Okay, good afternoon to everyone, and welcome to this new webinar from Geomax about XPAD Ultimate. In this webinar, we will continue our series of webinar about XPAD Ultimate. So now we are with module 3, so the third webinar about XPAD Ultimate. And today we will speak in particular about some advanced function to draw in the field, some advanced function of CAD, and we will see in detail how we can export the data in VXF, that is probably the most used format to export the survey data. So the topics of today, we will have a very quick review of what we have seen in the last webinar, and then we will have we will see for this module 3, we will talk about the smart drawing tools, we will talk about some advanced drawing tools and CAD function that we have in XPAD, and then to conclude our webinar we will see in detail, that is a topic that has been requested several times to explain in detail, so I am happy that here we have the opportunity to talk about. We will see in detail the different options that we have in XPAD Ultimate to export the VXF. If you have any question, you can directly write the question in the chat, and then I will reply to your question at the end of the webinar. So what are the goals for today? So what we will learn from this online, quick online training. So how to use the smart drawing option to draw during the survey. It is a topic that we already have seen in the last webinar that we did for XPAD Ultimate, but here we will see again and some of the functions we already have seen. But also we will understand how to use the advanced drawing option, in particular the line work, to draw with lines and codes. Then we will see some of the advanced CAD function that we have. And then as a final goal for today, we will understand the different options that we have when we export the VXF file. Okay, so in the last episode, what we have seen last time, we have seen how we can create and manage a code list. We have seen how to measure topographic points. So we have seen how to use the function measure and store to store only very quickly the point, or to store the point also taking the picture and the photo together with a point. We have seen how to create the points and do basic operation in the CAD. So today we will see more in detail how to do these operations in the CAD. And then as last topic of our last webinar, we have seen some of the COGO functions that we have in XPAD. Okay, let's start immediately with today module. So advanced survey and CAD functions. Okay, let's start talking about the survey point. This is already something we have seen last time. So in XPAD we have two different options to measure and measure and store. So I can also show directly here my tablet, that is much better. So if we open the survey point page, you see here we have two options. In this case, I am showing you the software with the robotic, but these functions are exactly the same if we use a GPS. You see here we have two options, measure and measure and store. What is the difference? Sorry, just activate the laser pointer. What is the difference? So if we measure, we just click measure and store, you see the points is immediately measured. Here, the point 100, and stored in our database. Otherwise, if we use the option measure, you see, we take the point, then we can change some option if we have not changed it before, like the code description. We can make a picture, we can take a photo with the tablet, and we can check the result. So this is the difference when between measure and measure and store. Then we have also other option. For example, you see we can change the point ID, the point number. We can use a code using the code list that we have inside our job. we talked in the last webinar, how to create, import, and customize the code list. And then here we have also different options to view the data. So by default, the view is a 2D view from the top, okay? But we can also change from a north view, in this case is the azimuth zero. The view that is the, you see now it's rotating the view, because in this case is the view from my point of view, from where I'm working. Or we can click on the finger to have the free view. So with the free view, we can zoom in, zoom out, and move the view on where we prefer. Or we can also work in 3D. You see, in 3D, also here, we can see, for example, you see the data, again, fixed on the total station point of view, or we can also have a free view. You see, in this case, everything is in 3D. Total station, the point, but this will be very nice also when I will have a 3D surface, for example, 3D elements, because everything will be displayed in 3D. Okay, but let's talk about the drawing that is the main focus of our webinar. So in XPAD Ultimate, we have two different methods to draw during the field job. The Smart Drawing Tools or the Line Work. So Smart Drawing Tools is the most easy way to draw, because in this case, we don't use any code, any control code. It's very simple. We just click here on point. We select the drawing elements that we need. So for example, we can start creating some lines. So I select line. So I measure the first point of the line. Okay. Now, let's use this view. Okay, second point. Okay, now we continue. And so on. Okay, so you see we can easily draw during the survey. Okay, so here you see it is very, very easy and fast to directly draw. So we can draw a line, for example. We can draw an arc, a square, circle. So for example, let's do a square by 2 points, for example. So I will take the first point and the second point. You see the software immediately creates the square. So you see it is very easy. We do not need to define any control code, any specific code. We just select the geometric elements we want to draw and we directly draw. Also, if we want, for example, to continue the drawing that we did before, so if we want to continue this line, we just click on the last point of the line and then directly we can continue our drawing. You see, it is very easy and very fast. And then we can click here and tap off the geometric element of the object that we want to draw. So this is what I call the easy way to draw, because we just click here on the Smart Drawing Toolbar, and here we define the geometric elements that we want to draw, point, line, arc, spline, circle, square, and so on. And we directly draw. However, we have also an advanced way to draw that is called line work. So let me create quickly another job. Okay, so I will continue using this station setup. It's only an example. So I want to start with a fresh job. What is the line work? So if we select here lines, you see here we have the line manager. So here in the line manager, we can create different line. So for example, imagine that here I have a road. So with this road, I will have three line. So left axis, center line, and right axis. So here I need, in this case, I need to have the code with the three line. So I will click on new and I will start with left axis, okay? So it's a code that I already have, but in case I don't have, I can also create the code. So left axis, Then I will use centerline and right axis. Okay, I can search it, it's faster. Okay, and here I have the three codes. Now that I have the three codes, I can directly select the code. In this case, I will start with left axis. And you see, in this case here, is selected the code left axis and the first point of the line. Okay, and now I will continue to draw the left axis. 1, 2, 3 point. Okay, now I want to change the road. So for example, I continue use, so I can directly click here or from here and I select center line. Okay, you see, I have 0 point on center line. And now I will measure the center line. First point, so for example, I will measure 2 point on the center line. And then I want to also measure the right axis. So I can also write directly the code. So there is already an active line. Do you want to create a new line? No. So I will continue using the line I already created. And here I also will take 3 points on the right axis. Okay. If now, for example, I want to continue the center line, I just select the center line and I will continue the existing line. So you see, it is a more advanced way to work with line and with code, okay? So this is what we call line work. But in this case, compared to the smart drawing tools, also we need to have the correct code. So we need to have the correct code and the code they have to be line. If we deactivate all the active line, we switch back to the old method. So here, for example, we can draw line square with the old method without any code. Otherwise, if we click here, we open again the line work. So what I like of Xpad is that we have these two different methods to draw, smart drawing tools and the line work. So one that is, I would say, a bit more easy, and the other one that is more advanced. Another very interesting function that we have with the smart drawing lines or the line work is the automatic survey of point. Automatic drawing of point is more correct. And here we have two options, zigzag and same direction. For what we need to use this option? So if we need to measure different line, it is more easy to walk between crossing the different line. For example, with zigzag. So I will work. I will start, for example, from the left axis. Okay, so I will measure the first point. Then the software automatically will switch to center line. Sorry, I got the wrong point. Okay, no problem. Then I will switch to center line. You see, the software automatically switch to center line. Then it will switch to right axis. And then it will be again right axis because I am doing a zigzag survey on the three line. Right axis, center line, left axis. And then it will be again left axis, center line, right, right, center, left, center, right, and so on. And in this case, you see that this is the road that I am drawing. In case, for example, I do not need to measure the left axis, I can also click here, and here you see I have the function skip, pause, stop at the end that I can use to skip a point or directly switch to the next line. Okay, so this is a more advanced way to work with the line. Let's go back quickly to the presentation to show what we have seen. So we have seen how to use measure and measure and store to record the different topographic point, and also how we can change the view. So we can work in 2D, we can work in 2D with the fixed view, we can work in 2D with the free view, we can also work in a fully 3D environment, where all the elements that we have, they are in 3D. And now more and more we are used to work in 3D. Also, a lot of time the data that we import are 3D data, so that has very interesting view to use. So 3D also, we can work with the fixed 3D view or the free 3D view. If we have a GPS, we can also work with the background maps. So for example, we can use Google as a background. And also, as we have seen, if we use the option measure a point, we can also, for example, take a picture. Then we have seen more in detail the drawing tools that we have. As we said, we have two different way to work in XPAD. One of these method is what we call smart drawing. So smart drawing is an independent method from codes, control codes. So we just select a point, and what is this point? Is a line, is an arc, is a spline, and we directly draw. Also, what is important to remember is that, for example, if we select line and we select the code house, for example, then when we will export the DXF, that line will be on the layer house. So will be at the end, we will have already the final output that is not only done with the full drawing, but is also complete with the correct layers. So we have the smart drawing tools that are very easy to use, very fast, and then we have also the line work. So line work allow a more advanced way to draw line using the code. So we need, first of all, to have or create some codes, and then we choose the code, and all the line will be in the correct, all the points stored to a line will be in the correct line. Okay, so here we have seen the different option, and also a function that we have in the line work is, for example, zigzag or same direction that we can use to automatically draw the line. So for example, if we use zigzag, we measure the first point, so right axis in this case, for example, the center line, left, and then we move to the left because at the end it's more fast. If with my prism or GPS I cross the road in this way, it's much more fast than measure one line, then back to the second line, and back to the third line. In this case, I walk with this zigzag movement, and then the software automatically will create the tree line. So this is something that I can only do if I'm using the line work. Okay, so this was the first part of our webinar. Now we can speak something more about the CAD. So in XPAD, you probably already know that we have a CAD integrated. So we can open the CAD from here, from the main menu, clicking on CAD, or we can also directly double click on the screen and we can open the CAD. What we have in the CAD? So in the CAD, we have these four macro functions, so data, draw, edit, and info. So let's have a look what we have here. Maybe let me open another job with some more drawing so we can work a bit more. Okay, let's open this job. So here we have, you see, is data with some is a project with some more data inside. Okay, let's switch on the layer. So first of all, as you see here in the CAD, we have also a layer manager. So if we click here on the left on this icon, we can open the layer manager. So here in the layer manager, we see all the layers that we have with the color. We can also click here to open the complete layer manager, similar to a CAD software. Here we can see all the layers that we have with the color and the type of the line. We can also change a color, for example, or we can also switch off a layer. For example, okay, maybe let's find a layer where I have some more data. For example, if I select, okay, you see, if I switch off this layer, all this line that are on this layer will be switched off. So it's a very nice tool to directly switch on, switch off, and manage all the layers. Also, if we import an AutoCAD file, here we will find all the layers that was belonging to the DXF file. So we will find all the layers here in the layer manager. Okay, so what we can do, first of all, the data, so we can see the data in 2D. This is the same that also we have in the survey, but we can also see the data in 3D. Okay, so you see, this is, for example, is a 3D Dixap. So we can see everything also in 3D, not only in 2D, or we can also see the data with the map as background. So you see, in this case, I am overlapping to Google Map, the DXF data that is georeferenced, and also these two green points that are two GPS points that I measured in the field. So you see, and here I have also, in case I want, the possibility to change type of map or use web map services. Okay, this is a very nice feature to see the data directly overlapped to online maps. But let's go back to the default view in 2D. So we was talking about data, draw, edit, and info. So with data, we have some function to import, export the DXF, change some settings of the CAD, so the label that we want to see, the background color, and so on. But what I want to show you now is the working area. Working area is a very useful function if we want to zoom in a specific area in our job. So for example, here I have imported a big DXF file, but at the end, for example, I only work in this area. Okay, this is the area where I will do my stakeout. So I want to have a defined zoom. So in this case, I will click on data, working area, define a working area. So adjust the view. So I said, okay, this is the view that I need, and I click on okay. Working area has been defined. So now, if I will click on this icon for the full zoom, you see the zoom will be only in this specific area. So this is very useful function if I have a big DXF, but I only want to zoom in a specific area. And then I can also remove it. Okay, draw. So draw, we have the possibility to draw line, polyline, arc, circle, what we want. So for example, if I want to draw a line between these two points, I can go in draw, line, and then similar to an AutoCAD software, I have also the snap, so extreme, medium, perpendicular, node. So I will exactly snap and select my point in the correct position. So you see, I click here and the software take exactly the point because I selected the snap extreme. Okay, and here I have created the line. Also, when I create the line, I will create the line on the layer that I selected here on the list. Okay, so at the end it's like to have an AutoCAD software. Also here, sorry, what I want to show you is this function layout. It is very interesting and I want to show you a bit more in detail how this function layout works. So layout is a tool that we can use if we need to create a point in the field to stake out. So for example, we are in a job site and we are doing a foundation layout. So we need to stake out a foundation, but in this case, maybe we do not have a DXF file. Maybe we have only an alignment, some points, and then we have only the plan, the project with the different distance and direction to make the stakeout. In this case, we can use this tool layout to easily create a point with a specific angle and distance. So here we can choose what we want to create. Let's create everything, point and line. And here we have the different options. So first of all, what we want to create? A line. I will start from this point, so I directly click and I say, okay, from this point I want to create a new point, 3 meters far away for the distance, and here I will select the azimuth. So here I can manually enter the azimuth, but it is probably more useful to click here and select by 2 points. So for example, I can take the direction between these 2 points as my reference direction. And then you see the blue arrow that change. This will be the 4 direction where I'm going to create the point, because I can change the increment. And then you see I'm creating the point. So create this point, then maybe I move 90 degrees, here, and so on. Okay, so you see here I have created the 4 points. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so it is very easy to use this function layout to directly draw the point according to a defined distance and azimuth. So for a lot of stakeout operation where I do not have the AutoCAD file, but maybe you have only the plan, the blueprint, then it is a very useful function that I can use in the field before the stakeout. Okay, now I want to show you the edit function. So edit function are function that we can use for a lot of different operation in the field. Also in this case to create point without using the COGO, but directly doing it in the field. So for example, I can show you the offset. So we can use the offset to create an offset of an object. So for example, I can select this line and I want to make an offset 1 meter here on the right. So you see, very easily I have created an offset of that line. And then when I have created this offset, maybe I want to create a point every 3 meter. So in this case, I will use the function measure. I select the line, 3 meter, and the software automatically created a point on the offset line every 3 meters. And then I can select the point and click on stakeout. You see, very easy and very fast. But also I have some other function that normally we find in COGO. So for example, I don't know, intersection with two distance. So I can select the point and I enter the distance, 6 meters. You see here I have the graphic preview, second point. Okay, let's do 6 meter. Here I have the two option. So I can click, select the point, select the solution, and I have created, the point on the intersection on the two distances. So you see, it is very easy because we only work with the graphic in this case. So we have done a COGO operation directly in the CAD without using any just few number. At the end, everything was done graphically. So it is also very easy to use these functions. Last set of functions that we have in CAD are the info function. So info function, we can use them to ask information to our job. So for example, ED, we can use to query a point. Okay, this was exactly the origin with the coordinate zero. Select another one, I don't know, this point that we just created. And you see here, we can check the coordinate east, north, and elevation. So we can check the different information. Then we have, for example, distance. So distance, we can use it to check the distance between the 2 points that we have. So we have the 2D distance, 3D distance, the coordinate of the 2 points, and so on. So the slope, distance to a point, to an object, for example. So reference point, select the object, and we see, we check the distance between the blue arrow, so a distance between a point to an object. Angle, so and we can check an angle between this point and this point. And here we have 90 degree, 100 gone, that is 90 degree, that is this angle here. Last function I want to show you is the area. So area, it is very easy because if, for example, I want to calculate this area between these points that I created, I just click on the point and then the software, you see, automatically create the area. Very easy. And then here we can see the area and perimeter. See, it is very easy and very useful function that I can use directly here on the graphic. Last function that I want to show you is the report. So report is an interesting function that allow to make an object report. It means that I can select different objects that I have in my drawing, and I can create a report. So for example, now I want to create a report of a polyline. So in this case, these are single, this polyline here. So I will select info, report. Here I can select also more than one object. So for example, I select this polyline and I don't know, for example, this line that I created. Okay. Here I can export my report in different format. Now to show you the report, I will select PDF and I will directly open the report. And this is the report that I have. So this will be a report with reported the information about the object I selected. So in this case, you see I have a polyline where I have not used any code, line 2D, line 3D, and if there is also an area. Then there is this line with this code, with this length. So this can be very useful to create report of the geometric object that I have in the CAD. Okay, so let's see just a quick summary of what we have seen. So we have seen the different functions that we have in CAD, CAD data, the drawing function, in particular the layout, and CAD info, CAD edit, we have seen, and the CAD info that we can use to interrogate the elements that we have, or this useful function to create report of the object that we have. Okay, for the last part of our webinar, I want to talk about the different export function that we have. Is a question that we receive few times. We received a few times from our customer asking what to explain what are the different options that we have and the meaning of the different options that we have when we want to export a CAD file. So let's open again here. So if we go in export, because for example, we want to export the survey that we have done in the field, and we select the DXF, you see here we have a lot of different options. So, but what is the meaning of these different options that we have? So let's go back to the presentation and we will see one by one the different options. So first of all, the version. So the first option that we see is version. So we can select AutoCAD 2018, 2016, and so on. At the end, it's just the compatibility. So if in Office we have the last version of Fixpad, even here select the last version for compatibility. It is just because some different element will be exported or not, or called in a different way, just for compatibility. Second option is called survey drawing. What does it mean? It is a function that I need to select if I want to export the graphic, the line, the line, arc, all the graphic that I measured during the survey. So for example, in the first part of this webinar, we have seen the smart drawing tools, the line work, and we created some line for our example. If this option is selected in AutoCAD, I also will export the line. If this option is off, I will only export the topographic point. So all the line will not be exported. Third option is the drawing. So drawing means that not the line that I measured during the survey, but the pure drawing elements that I have will not be exported. So in this case, for example, can be the drawing that I have previously imported from another DXF file, for example. So you see, in this case, in Xpad, I have a survey and a drawing. If I select yes, that I also want to export the drawing, in this case, I will export everything in CAD. Otherwise, this part, the drawing that I have in Xpad, will not be exported. This could be useful in case I import an AutoCAD file, then I start my job, I make a survey, and at the end, I only want to export my survey and not the drawing that I have imported. Export 3D, okay, this is self-explaining. So if I select yes, my points will be exported with the real elevation or the elevation that we have measured in the field. If I select no, simply all the points will have elevation zero. Export layer off. This option allow to export or not the layers that I have deactivated in XPath. So for example, you see here on the left, this screenshot, I have this layer, is called 7L000MD. It is switched off, okay? When, if the option export layer off is yes, when I will export the DXF, I will have this layer in AutoCAD, even if it will be switched off. If this layer is this option is no, this layer and all the data belonging to this layer that is switched off in XPath will be removed, will be deleted. So in my CAD software, I will not have this layer. Okay, then we have another option, how we export the point. Here we have five different options. So export point, we have don't export any point, block with attribute and symbol, block with attribute and drawing point, exploded with text and symbol, exploded with text and drawing point. This is one of the options that we all introduced in one of the last updates that we did. So let's see what all this option means. Okay, this is what we have in XPath, okay? So in XPath, we measure the point that is called 110P. We have this elevation, 71 meters. The code is lamp and the description is lamp. We have the topographic point, that is this green point that you see. And also we have a symbol, because you know that in XPath, we can also have a code and a symbol. So in this case, we also have a symbol. If we select don't export point, okay, simply, we do not export any point in AutoCAD. So all the topographic points will not be exported. Maybe we only want to export the drawing. We don't care about the point. Second option, if we select export block with attribute and symbol, you see in AutoCAD, I will export everything, all the label, and label plus symbol will be in a single block, in a single CAD block, will not be exploded. If instead we select block with attribute and drawing point, you see the difference is that I will not use the symbol that I defined in XPath, but I will use the default graphic that I have in CAD for the point. So in this case, I have the cross to mark the point. But even in this case, point plus description, elevation, all the labels will be in a single block. Third option, option number four and five. Here, if I select exploded with text and symbol, again, I will export the symbol, but it will be exploded. So I will have a single text and single symbol. So I can select, they will not be in a single block in the CAD software. And exploded with text and drawing point will be the same as before. It will be exploded, but in this case, I will have the point symbol and not the symbol that I used in the CAD in XPath. Label sites. So label sites, even here, we just define the size of label. So in this case, probably is a bit confusing it's a bit confusing the screenshot because I'm not increasing the size of the symbol, I am decreasing the size of the label. So here the size of the label was 0.5, this is 0.2. So it looks that the symbol is bigger, but they are big the same, just the text is smaller. Okay, so here we can just define the size of the label. Other option is called label on layer of point. What does it mean? If this option is selected yes, the different label, so point ID, elevation, code description, will be on the same layer of the point. So in this case, you see that I have a layer that is called utility that I use it to measure this point. If this option is yes, all the labels will be together with the point on the layer utility. If I deselect this option, instead they will be in a separate layer. So I will have a layer called, you see, point name, point elevation, point description. So the label will be on the correct layer. Export sketch. This is used if I, so is recommended to select on if I also stored the pictures during my survey. So if in my survey, for example, for the point 110P, I also recorded this picture, then you see when I export the DXF, I will have an hyperlink. You see, control and click to follow the link to open the picture that in this case is a geotagged picture. Okay, so this is the picture that I took in the field with XPAD, and then I will have an hyperlink in the CAD software to open the picture. Last of the option that we have is a label to export. So in all the example, we exported all the label, point name, this one, point elevation, point code, and point description. But at the end, maybe I do not need, maybe I just need the code, so I can switch off point name, elevation, and description, and I just will have one single label that is called point code. Then, after we have understood and all these options that we have, so you see, these are all the options that we selected before, okay? So, but you see, it's good that now we know the meaning of the different options that we have. We have two different options how to save the data. So, device or cloud. So, device or cloud means that my job, so survey, for example, DXF, will be saved directly in my internal memory of the tablet inside this folder. Or if I click on this button, I will export directly to an USB pen drive if it is plugged in the tablet, or I can also click on cloud. So with cloud, I can also directly save my data to Dropbox, Google Drive, or OneDrive. So you see, I have different options to save. So I can save it internal memory, I can save it to a pen drive, or I can save it to a cloud server. If instead I select share file, I will use the option that I available already in Android. So depends on the application and the function of my Android, but then I can, for example, share the file by Bluetooth, share the file as an email attachment. You see, you have different options, but this option depends on the application that I have saved in my, that I have installed in my tablet. So for example, you see, if I select Gmail, so the software automatically will create an email with the job DXF attached as, and then here I can send the email directly with the, I can send directly the email, you see, with the job as an attachment to my email. Okay. So this concludes our webinar. I hope you found interesting information. If you have any question, you can write your question here in the chat and I will reply to your question. In the meantime, if you want to enter some questions, I will upload quickly this presentation. Sorry, I will. Here I have already created the PDF, so I am uploading the PDF of this presentation. So if you want, you can download from the Hangouts menu this the PDF of this presentation. I also would like to remember you that if you open here in our GeoMax website, you open the page Service and Support Webinar. Here you can find all the old webinar that we did. So for example, this was the module 2 of XPAD Ultimate. So you can directly select the webinar that you want to see it again. You enter just your email and Watch now, and you will receive on your email the link to see again the webinar. Also, the webinar that we have just did, it will be uploaded, I think, in the next 3 days, so for sure before end of the week. And if you go here in webinar, you will have the possibility to see again the webinar. Okay, I see just one question, so we'll reply this question. So probably I was clear. I hope this is the reason. And the question is about to explain again the meaning of the label when we export the CAD. So label we can define in different page of our export. So the meaning of label is that when we export the DXF, a DXF file together with the topographic point, we have different information. And these different information are the point name, the point elevation, so the elevation that we measured for that point, the code, and the description. So when we export the DXF, first of all, we can choose what of this information we want to create together with the point. If we want, we can also switch off all these different labels, because maybe we just need the cross of the point. We don't care about this label. Then this label will also be saved in different layer. So first of all, we select the label that we want, so name, code, description, elevation, and then we can choose if we want this label in the same layer of the point. So for example, if I measure the point with the layer utility, this label will be in the layer utility. If I switch select no, this label will be every label in a specific layer for all the point. And then, okay, I can also specify the size of the label. And then here I can choose how I can export the point. So if I want that point and label will be in a block, so when I will open this data in a CAD, point and label or symbol will stay all in a single block, or otherwise if they are exploded. So if in this case I can select separately the symbol, the point, and each of these of the different label that are considered as a text. In the other case, it was considered for a block. So if I go back here in our tablet, here, AutoCAD DXF, you see here, these are all the options related to the point. So here I define what are the labels that I want to export, and here I the export. For example, I want to export everything exploded with the drawing point, and here the sites, if the label have to be in a separate layer or not, and so on. Okay. Okay, if there are no other questions, I would like to thank you again for your participation, and I wish you a nice continuation of your day.